And we are very, very happy here to have the Engineer-in-Chief, Mr. Nalla Venkateshwarlu here to address the audience and share his experiences. He has a wealth of experience of over 29 years, and his visionary leadership has helped overcome several project challenges in this massive project. May I request Mr. Venkateshwarlu Nalla to please come onto the stage and share his experiences with us?
I am Venkateshwarlu, the engineering chief of the Great Kaleshwaram project. I am here to share my experiences in this great engineering marvel project. You know, this project has started just 3 years back with an intention to give in this gigantic project many works have been taken up. It's a combination of 28 projects which will be calling it as a big gigantic project of this Telangana, and it should be a proud of a nation. Let us see the details of this project and also what management we made in construction of this project in a record time of 24 months. That is a great job of this project. This was inaugurated, this was Bhumi Puja performed by our Honorable Chief Minister Garu, the first CM of Telangana state. Soon after getting Telangana state, our Honorable CM sir has taken up a view on the entire irrigation projects of Telangana state. We have about almost 33 major projects in our Telangana state, but only few have been completed before formation of Telangana. So this is on 2nd May 2016. The Bhumi Puja was performed. Here this slide will explain us the background of project. Earlier it was called as Dr. B.R. Ambedkar Pranati Chevalla Sujala Stravanti, which was taken up in the year of 2008 and 2009, and it was in 28 works. With an intention or with a contemplation to give water to 16.4 lakh acres in Telangana region, which is also having border state as our Maharashtra. The DPR was submitted to the Central Water Commission, which is the highest authority, to go into the details of the detailed project report, which has been submitted by the then government of Andhra Pradesh. There the CWS has raised certain points as per their observations. Majorly they are in three numbers. In this proposal, we have the inadequate storage, that's of 14.70 MC against 162 MC proposed earlier. And also, the inadequacy in utilizable water availability at the location of Tamadi Hetti, which is located in erstwhile Adilabad district. And also the disproportionate of submergence area, which we can see from this slide, that 87% in Maharashtra and 13% in Telangana, which was not agreed by the government of Maharashtra. We made proposal to construct a barrage at Tumide Hetti with a level of 152 meters. But at that level of 152 meters, we had 87% submergence in Maharashtra and also 13% in Telangana. That made them to raise the concern for construction of the first barrage, which was proposed earlier at Tamadi Hetti. Apart from that, we have other issues like forest issues and also the wildlife sanctuary just beside of the original proposal of this barrage at Tamadi Hetti. So after continuous persuasion with the government of Maharashtra by the our first Honorable CM of Telangana state, Sri K. Chandrasekhar Garu, made all efforts to make them convinced for a reduced level of 148 to continue this project by re-engineering it. That means by making suitable changes to make use of this project fruits to the farmers of Telangana state. So all these led to re-engineering of this project, which has taken up by our Honorable CM sir personally by reviewing all the features of this project and made lot of changes in the construction of this gigantic project. And the earlier project has been made into two projects. That is, one is B.R. Ambedkar Pranahita project confined to the erstwhile Andhrabad district, now which has been made into four districts there. And earlier the proposal was 50,000 acres, and now it has been made to 2 lakh acres in that region, very backward area of the Adilabad district is. So the second project is our Kaleshwaram project. Here we proposed 3 barrages and also 3 main lift systems at different locations by utilizing the bed of Godavari River as our storage, without taking a single acre for the submergence of these storages. So which we can see here from the slide, 3 barrages and 3 pump houses, which were replaced our link 1, because this project was made with 7 links. So the first link was detached and now made a separate project, which is serving the Adilabad district for an acre of 2 lakh acres. And the new one, the Kaleshwaram project, which has been named as Kaleshwaram project, as its intake barrage is proposed at Medigadda on the Godavari River instead of Pranahita. But after joining of Pranahita at Kaleshwaram, and also we know that the Kaleshwaram is famous for Lord Shiva temple, so in the name of Lord Shiva temple, this project has been renamed as Kaleshwaram project. And we can say that this is one of the world biggest irrigation project with series of lifts taken up by the government of Telangana. The aim of this project is, it's a multi-purpose project to provide water for irrigation to an acre of 45 lakh acres against 16.4 lakh acres earlier proposed, and also to provide 10 TMC of drinking water to the villages en route, and also to provide 30 TMC as drinking water to twin cities of this Hyderabad and Secunderabad. Today we are taking the water for the drinking purpose and also for our day-to-day utilization solely from Godavari, and that too from Elambelli project, which is also a part of Kaleshwaram project. And fourth, it is for giving water to the industrial purpose. And these are the districts going to be benefited in Telangana state. Almost 60% of the area is going to be irrigated with the benefit of this collection project after construction, and also to stabilize the aqueduct in 19 districts of Telangana. The details are we can see here, and these are the salient features of Kaleshwaram project. What we can see here, the aqueduct now we proposed for 45 lakh acres against 16.4 lakh acres earlier we proposed, and with the system of gravity canal and the tunnels, pressure mains, pump houses, reservoirs and the barrages, the three barrages we have provided to satisfy the suggestion made by the Central Water Commission to increase the storage capacities from 14.7 TMC to 141 TMCs. Because we must give the assurance to the farmers to sustain their aqueduct, whatever they're going to cultivate during the future course of time. And the power requirement is 4,627 megawatts. But nevertheless, we don't require the total power in a season because of the number of links involved in this project, numbering to 7 links. So all the links, we are not going to operate simultaneously. So according to the need and also the rainfall occurred in the areas will be considered for functioning or commissioning of the pump houses, which are numbering almost 19 numbers in the Telangana state, particularly in northern Telangana, where this Godavari river is flowing. So the cost of this project is 80,190 crores. The DPR has been submitted, and also the cost estimate has been furnished to the CWC for their clearances. We obtain all the clearances from the CWC for the taking up this gigantic Kaleshwaram project. And the power demand we can see there. And the apart from these structures, we are also constructing, we are also establishing the substations, which are also numbering into 19. The lifts are about 21. So this is the detail, you know, showing about the availability of the water in Godavari Basin. As far as the erstwhile AP is concerned, we have 1480 TMC of water allocation in Godavari River because it is running for a length of 2,000 kilometers from the Trimbak of Maharashtra state, and it's joining Bay of Bengal after passing AP. So from there, the share of Telangana is 954 TMC and the Andhra share is 526 TMC. But we could not take this water as much of the lands of Telangana state at higher level. So we are already exhausted by constructing our projects by gravity, by taking up almost 10 to 11 projects earlier, and also the 22 projects presently are ongoing projects where we are going to utilize the maximum possible amount of water that to be lifted from Godavari. As they are at higher levels, we have no chance to take this water to our fields by gravity, but it is a combination of gravity and lifts by which way we are giving water to the farmers through this gigantic project. So there even still we have the 51 TMC balance water in this Godavari basin as a share of our Telangana state. So in a nutshell, if we see into the details of this project, we can say that this is an apex project, and also it is an engineering marvel. Why we are saying it is an engineering marvel? We have a lot of underground structures also. Normally we will be seeing surface structures, but we have taken up more number of subsurface structures. After going into a depth of almost 145 meters, we have constructed infra inside, like pump houses, such pools, and also control rooms, substations. They're all underground. So we have done them successfully, and very recently we commissioned two links very successfully. So we have got all clearances from CWC and taken environmental considerations into account from the stage of project designing to implementation. The simultaneous growth of compensatory afforestation, because this also involving certain area of forest for the construction of this Kaleshwaram project. that these are the three barrages we have taken up, we have constructed in a record time of 24 months only by exuding almost 90,000 cubic of concrete in a period of 20 to 21 months. So that is the greatness of our Telangana government and also the civil engineers from the government of Telangana. This is shaping of our Kaleshwaram project. Of course, it might have been started in the year of 2004 and 5 as a formulation of this project. The proposals were made during the year of 2004 and 5, and then the agreements entered in the year of 2007 and 9, because it's for 2 years, we made into 28 works, which have been called as 28 packages. And in the year of 15-16, that too after getting our Telangana, on 2nd June 2014, the Honorable CM Sir, the first CM of our Telangana state, sat together with the senior engineers, retired engineers, and also with working engineers, and apprised about his opinion, because he's a great visionary CM Sir, and had very good vision about the availability of the water, not only in Telangana state, and also throughout India. He knows where the water is available, how to use the water for the welfare of the farmers of India. So with that concept, he made a lot of changes in the earlier project and now made it suitable for the giving water by increasing its capacity of the irrigation to be done from 16.4 lakh acres to 45 lakh acres. Imagine how much quantum of area has been increased for giving water to the irrigation purpose. And apart from that irrigation, he also gave a lot of importance for the drinking purpose and also for the industrial utilization. So it's nothing but a multi-purpose project. And again, after making all the changes, necessary changes in the proposals of earlier project, now it has been given a rebirth and a reshape to this project. And where we can see the sequence of the operations and the discussions what we followed. So previously we can see them. These are the key achievements so far we seen in this project. Statutory clearances in a record time we obtained and set a record by pouring 16,722 cubic meters in a period of 24 hours. So that was a record because it is being done in a thickly reinforced structure. A lot of reinforcement was involved. It's not a PCC we poured. It is an RCC structure we constructed. And we can see the storage of water in terms of static storage, which is amounting to 43.15 TMC, so far achieved out of 141 TMC. It is also in a record time of almost 19 months, we achieved it. And the first lifting of water by our Kaleshwaram project was witnessed on 24th April 2019 in Package 6 near Medaram, in the village of Medaram and Dharmaram Mandal of Pedapalli district. And over 3 years, we obtained 15,782 acres of land for the construction. As all of we know that for any construction, the first foremost thing is to get the land for construction. Any facility or any infra you want to develop, the first and foremost thing is getting the land for creating the structure. So here the government has taken up an interest over this and resolved the issues. Wherever we need the land acquisition for the construction of this gigantic project, at minute level, considering the facts at minute level and also at field level, the issues have been resolved and a lot of land we have taken by convincing the farmers, by making the payment as they wish. And it has been done and successfully we started the works almost at all project sites. And the photographs we can see here, that is the first pump house. We'll be calling it as a Bahubali 1, where the pump's capacity is very high in terms of discharge and also its power capacity. They are in the capacity of 125 megawatts each pump, and the discharging capacity is 3,150 cubic each. So we have 7 pumps there, and at second pump house, which is also an underground pump house, and there we had the similar number of pumps, but the capacities are varying because of the difference in height. So these are the total several links we have in this project, in which link 1, link 2 are very crucial. They are the source for giving the water to the entire area of northern Telangana, which is covering almost 60 to 70% of the Telangana state. Now just we can look into the key statistics. What are the quantum of works to be done? The major quantity of the works, the earthwork, how much we have to do, and also the total concrete, how much we are going to do. So there are the details. And out of, you know, from this slide, we can see the total concrete is showing as 175.58 lakh cubic meters. Out of that, so far, we have done 1.2 crores, that is 120 lakh cubic meters of concrete has been done in a record time of 21 months. So that is the greatness of our civil engineers from Telangana state. And also we utilized a lot of cement. You can see from these figures, 42.50 lakh metric tons. It's a very huge quantum of cement. We got them from different cement companies, and they were supplied continuously by the agencies of cement companies. And we can just look at the peak manpower deployment, because it all will come under project management. How nicely we have done the project management without any support from any agency. It's purely from the successful guidance of our Honorable CM Garu and the then Honorable Minister Garu and our special CS Irrigation and also CS of Government of Telangana. They gave us a lot of suggestions and also they conducted a lot of review meetings without wasting our time. Most of the review meetings were taken up only at project construction sites. So that definitely, you know, improved our efficiency, and also we made a lot of progress in the construction of these works. 50,484 labor were worked on this gigantic collection project on a single day, that is on 22nd March 2019, which is a month where the maximum work progress can be achieved. So that is the way of doing this construction of project. And we have the labor from almost 27 states out of 29 states of our great India. So we had the labor from different parts of country, and they were with us for making this engineering marvel structure of college frame project. Here we can see the details of the first link. Normally, the projects have been constructed on a flowing river. The river flows from higher level to lower level. But here, we made a history by asking the river to travel in reverse direction. And it has been done practically, and we have filled up the entire river for a length of 110 kilometers successfully before starting off flows into the Godavari River. It's a man-made wonder, and it belongs to all our fraternity of intellectuals as well as the engineers. Here you can see the first intake point where we are getting a lot of water. It's going and joining the Bay of Bengal without utilization. Almost 3,000 to 3,500 TMC per year we are leaving the water into the Bay of Bengal. But the visionary Honorable CM sir, he made the proposal to utilize the maximum water which is going as a waste into the Bay of Bengal, as the ocean. So instead of that, we try to give the maximum water to the poor farmers of our Telangana state, because almost 90% of our population of Telangana state depending on only on agriculture. So that gives us a great satisfaction in completion of these gigantic projects, and also for getting a chance to work in this world record, you know, world treating as a marvel, an engineering marvel structure of this decade, we can say. So here from barrage, which is having a capacity of 16.17 TMC, normally the barrages will not have that much of capacities. It will be ranging only from 5 TMC to 10 TMC. But here, we made its capacity as 16.17 TMC at the level of 100 mains level. And there at that level, we have the capacity with 16.17 TMC. And also having a backwater effect of almost 65 kilometers in the river of Godavari as well as Pranahita. So this is the first pump house. You know, the distance between the barrage and the pump house is about 24 kilometers. By way, we reduce the cost, because if you keep the pump house only at the location of our Godavari, its cost will be increasing. So instead of that, by using the same principle, that is gravitational force, we increase the level of water by keeping an obstruction in flowing river like Godavari and diverted the water in reverse direction. Practically, we have seen it has given good response as per our design requirement when we started stopping the water by making artificial obstruction in the flow of river. So that made us to reduce the cost and also to reduce the time for getting the water from one place to other place. So this slide is showing us the details of this link one, where we have tried successful and got the water from the lower level of almost 88 meters is the bed level in Godavari at Medigadda and lifted up to 152 meters. So that has been done successfully. So we can see the second barrage, second pump house, third barrage, third pump house from this topo sheet where we are showing all the details in link one, because it is a crucial for us. So there, by applying our stoppage of water by means of erection of gates and closing them after completion of the work, we can see the water, how it is flown. It's flown in reverse direction. Then now entered into pump house also by gravity. Once it entered into the pump house, then from there the first lifting will be started. So we have started lifting. It is lifted, water is lifted in reverse direction, went into the delivery system. From there is passing through the gravity canal and reaching the second barrage, so which is having capacity of 11 TMC. So the second barrage having the capacity of 11 TMC and taking the water from the first barrage once it is receives the water during the rainy season. So that is the diagram where we are seeing the water flowing in reverse direction. So again, it's entered into second pump house. So that is our Annaram pump house, which is also in our Pedapalli district. So there it is going into the third barrage. So now, manually and also by taking the help of lifts, we are taking the water from lower level to higher level by using the technology in terms of gravity as well as lift. So then again, the capacity of third barrage is 8.83 TMC. So the total storage in the river Godavari is 36 TMC without single acre is obtained or acquired for the submergence. So we can call them as submergence free barrages and also silt free barrages, because we have taken very little bit silt. The silt is the height of structure to be raised for storage of water, but the entire water will be storing here only by means of gates. Once the gates are opened, the entire river water will go as if there is no structure at all. So that is the beauty of these three barrages, which are in sequence. And they are also shake hand barrages. So they are giving shake hand each other. So that is also there, which is regenerating the river, entire river, for a length of 110 to 115 kilometers. That we have achieved before receiving good flows into the river Godavari. So there again, from third barrage, we have the third lift, and it is taking the water from the third barrage to Ellampally project. The Ellampally project is also in this link one, and it is considered as a balancing reservoir for us for taking the water from there into other areas. So there, from the third lift, it is going to Ellampally project, and the Ellampally project was already taken up and having a capacity of 20.175 TMC. So totally, we are going to store 56 TMC of water, almost 56 TMC of water in the bed of Godavari River without difficulty, and only with smart lifts. There are simple lifts now having arranging the static head from 35 meters to 18 meters. So this slide showing us the linkman details as an abstract form. We also provided I-cut facility for the local farmers, 30,000 acres by gravity as well as by lift, proposing a small lift there, and storage capacity 36 TMC apart from LFLU project storage. That's you, if you add 20 TMC to it, it will be becoming 56 TMC. Three barrages, three pump houses, and the gravitational length is 21.17. So this, of course, we have already seen in the diagram, which has given us the flow direction also in this one. This is the first barrage, you know, this has been constructed in a period of 24 months, where we can see the details. They are the key features of this particular project. This Medigata barrage, where we can see its capacity, you know, 16.17 TMC, the length is 1.632 kilometers. This is the total length of the barrage. It's also facilitated us to start the conveyance for giving transportation of the people and, you know, the goods from right side Telangana state to left side Maharashtra state. So it's facilitating the people to move from one state to other state for improving their relations with the people of other state. So it is an interesting project, especially this Medigadda barrage is a multi-purpose project, and also it's an interstate project. We have a good coordination with the Maharashtra engineers and also the government of Maharashtra. They supported us a lot in the construction and completion of this project in a record time of 24 months. Here we can see the photograph showing the construction stage, where we have diverted the water from the flowing river, because from this point, the Godavari is perennial. Normally we'll say that the Godavari is perennial, but it is not true, because it's only half the way it is the perennial. Up to Kaleshwaram point, we will be seeing the water only now and then. It's not frequent, we are not seeing the water in the Godavari River, but whereas after Kaleshwaram, there we can see the river as a perennial river. So that means that the water will be flowing throughout the year. So this is the backwater effect of our barrage, where we can see the bridge which was constructed connecting both the states of Maharashtra and Telangana at Kaleshwaram. So at barrage, we have taken one of the methods in cutoffs, you know, upstream and downstream cutoffs should be there for controlling the seepage. So that where we have taken in the design of cutoffs using second piling. So the second piling normally will be utilized for the foundation of flyovers and bridges, that is for isolated footings. But whereas we made this technology for speedy construction and also safe construction, and to have the no seepage through it. So we made this construction that we can see here. The video is not playing, Jaeger. Yeah, this video is showing us the pouring of concrete in the raft. Because this barrage is longest barrage among three barrages, having a length of 1.632 kilometers, the width is 110 meters width, the raft width is 110 and thickness is 3 meters. And now, of course, it has been made 4 meters subsequently because of design requirement. And this was the videograph we have taken on 22nd December 2018, on which day we have created a world record. We continued the pouring of this concrete not for 24 hours, we even increased beyond that period, almost for 72 hours. 3 days it was continuous, by achieving almost 15 to 16,000 cubic meters per day. Yeah, it is an amazing pouring in our concrete field. So this is the video, you know, showing us the pouring of concrete and continuation of the work, concrete pouring work, even in the night time also, It was 24/7. The activity of construction has been carried out continuously by 24/7 by engaging the labor in shift system. It was continuous. Even our engineers also worked for 24/7. So because of the visionary legend of our Honorable CM sir of Telangana state, he made several suggestions to us. Sir used to talk with us very frequently with the engineering chief engineers, and also at the level of executive engineers to achieve the good progress and also to get the good quality of the works. So this, in the night, we can see the execution, what is going on there at Medigadda Barrage. This is the view of cover dam, what we constructed during the peak flood. You know, the actual execution was started in the year of 2017. The agreement was made in the year 2016, in the month of August. But we need almost 5 to 6 months to take the land for the construction of this barrage, which is about 1,200 acres. So we made the project management by deploying task force people from our own engineers. We did the job right from one department to other department, going from one place to one place, and achieved our targets for acquiring the lands. And especially in Maharashtra, it's very difficult situation for us to acquire the land, because there the registration requiring all the persons whose names are already recorded in the registers, they will be called as Sadbara registers. So 7/12 registers are there. There the family members' names will be, the total family should sign. They should have the internal agreement for giving the land to us for construction of this project. And we made, you know, all efforts by sending our own engineering teams to different areas of Maharashtra to call the persons, to take the persons from that area to Sirancha Taluka. Sirancha Taluka is the place where this left flank of this barrage is existing. So that is in the district of Gadchiroli of Maharashtra, where a lot of difficulties we found in acquiring the land, but the farmers are very supportive, very encouraging to us. They didn't stop a single day of this work of Medigadda barrage. Never we had any stoppage in this work, not only in this barrage, in all the works of our link 1, link 2. Nevertheless, it is continued continuously by 24/7. So here we can see this semi-permanent structure of cover dam is helping us in diverting the water and also controlling the dewatering. See, for construction of a structure, we need dry subsurface. That is, foundation is required to be dry. So making it dry, we have to dewater the entire water in the foundation of this riverbed where flow of water is for 24/7 and 365 days. So that methodology we have done. So this picture shows, you know, this is a bird view of that area where the execution was taken up. And this right side, we made this barrage into 8 blocks. So right side is the first block where we completed 5 gates first to divert the water during the lean flows. So because it is a perennial place where the water is flowing throughout the year, so therefore to continue the work without stoppage, we made alternative arrangements by constructing this cover dam. Here it's a semi-permanent cover dam where it has withstand for 9 lakh cusecs of water during the flood season. So this way we have diverted from block 1 into the 5 gates. And now we can see the project management issues, especially for the benefit of our audience. Here, in December 17th, the agreements were made in the year of 2016 in the month of August, but because of land acquisition process, it took time, and in the month of April 2018, we started foundation work. Then after that, the main concrete work has been started. So there, lot of issues were there, and it is also an extremist area, and apart from that, very backward area, no facilities are there. We have to bring a lot of labor, workmen, skilled persons to be brought to the site for execution of this project. So here we can see the details. December, then additional mobilization, and the total including augmented people, how much people we have brought, how many engineers have worked there. These are the details, you know, they are the actual details, because we have to maintain the strength of engineers as well as the labor who engage there. So that is there, and the farm work is very important for us for meet up the demand for the completion of the project in the limited period of construction. Because we have got only limited period. Normally, a barrage will require minimum 5 years to 10 years. For a small barrage also, you need minimum period of 5 years. But whereas we, the engineers, made the wonder by completing this project under the guidance of Honorable CM sir, in a period of 24 months, not only one barrage, all three barrages have been done simultaneously in a period of 21 to 24 months. So these are the machinery we mobilized. Batching plants having capacity of 870 cubic meters power. Even we can achieve the efficiency up to 30,000 cubic meters per day. That was our efficiency in producing the concrete from the various batching plants we erected, we commissioned there. So the boom placers and also the concrete mixtures. On the day of December 22nd, 2018, we deployed almost 120. Yeah. So other equipment we have like this. And this is the technology we utilize, you know, by using internet utilization. Internet on things like regarding our labor and machinery, everything controlled by our internet system to make it to improve the efficiency of the labor, workmen, and also the machinery. These are the highlights of one work at Medigadda. We have a similar program of works to be completed at all the barrages and also at all the pump houses. And this is the team where this is the core team of Medigadda, where we have done this record completion of work. There we can see the details. In 72 hours, we have completed 25,584 cubic meters of concrete. Then the reinforcement, you know, making of reinforcement is a difficult thing. There all the details are given here, 85 gates, the erection in 4 months, which is also a wonder. So far in our India, no project has been done with this speed, with this quality. You can see the safe hours, 13.9 million hours of safe hours have been achieved at this barrage and also at other barrages, where we have taken a lot of precautions for the safety of the labor, for the facility of the labor to be given at site. So productivity improvement, we can see our pair form work. They are the slides which are showing some of the highlights of the project where we have completed, you know. This is the ice plant we have erected at Medigadda barrage. The ice flakes are required to control the temperature in pouring of the concrete. And mobilization of the workforce also very much important for us for completion of this project in record time. Here we can see the gates fabrication. We have 85 gates in first barrage, second barrage having 66 gates, third barrage is having 74 gates. So altogether, a lot of gates are fabricated. They have been done by following a method which has been followed by Japan. So from there, we brought the machinery. Very latest machinery have been brought from there. And automated pull-through welding machine, no labor required. At a time, you can have the 12 pieces of any shape given by you to the computer. That is CNS cutting machine is there. With that help, we could complete the fabrication of all the gates in three barrages in a record time of 1 year and the erection of these gates in 4 months only. So here, the health concept well taken into consideration, and summer problems are also there. We can see from this slide, the details have been given by us, and the medical facility given to the labor working there to increase the confidence among themselves for creating a good atmosphere of work. So at last, after taking up, you know, after meeting up all the challenges and completing the project, we have the inauguration of this Medigadda barrage in the hands of three chief ministers. I think this is the first time in India all the three chief ministers of neighboring area have participated in the inauguration of this project. So this shows the friendly hand with the other states, the friendly nature of this Telangana state to be continued with the other states of our Telangana, neighbor states of Telangana. And you live and allow to live other people. That is the concept of our Honorable CM sir. And here, it was a great moment for all of our engineers, right from our assistant executive engineers to engineering chief. We're all proud to share these moments before all of you for completion of this gigantic project and in front of the Honorable Chief Ministers and also the Honorable Governor of both the states, AP and Telangana. And in front of ministers and MLAs, we have this function on 21st June 2019. That means, nevertheless, you know, it's only a period of 24 to 27 months. 24 months are required for completion of concrete works, and the balance maintenance works have been completed in a period of 3 months. And totally, the project was completed in a span of 27 months. That shows the entire project well before 3 years of period of construction. So here I'm just going speed, you know. We can see some details of pump houses. Here, this is the first pump house. And one more important thing to be noted here is that each pump house capacity is 3 TMC per day. I think nowhere in the world at a single point, no pumping station is having this capacity of 3 TMC per day. It is also a record, world record. And that has been achieved by our government of Telangana with the dedication to give the water to the poor farmers of Telangana state. Yeah. Yes, sir. I'm just, lunch is there. Yeah. Okay, sir. So this shows the photograph of our intake canal and the four-bay pump house. Normally, barrage components we have seen and lift system components are like this. So this shows the commissioning of first pump house, which is at Kannapilli village, Madhapur Mandal, Kaleshwaram near. So there we have commissioned the first pump on the day of inauguration itself. So the commissioning is also has been done by us successfully on 21st June 2019, before the honorable CMs of neighboring states and as well as our CMs are in the presence of Governor G. So this shows the second barrage and backwater of second barrage. This also shows the leading channel or the lead channel of 13.34 kilometers, starting first pump house to second barrage. This shows the picture of second pump house. Here also we can see a video graph showing the commissioning of second pump house. These are the highest lifting pumps in the world. These capacities we can't find in anywhere in our world. So this also has been done successfully by us in Link 1, Link 2. And this is our third barrage where we have done similar work. And this has been completed in a record time of 19 months. Medigata barrage in 24 months, second barrage in 17 months, third barrage in 19 months. So everything has been done before the completion of 2 years period. Pump houses, simultaneously we have taken up all the pump houses, where we have done 33 lakh cubic meters of concrete in all the three pump houses. So that is also a record. We have the open surface world record, and the world longest pump house, open pump house in the world is our first pump house at Kannapilli, which is in the name of Lakshmi pump house. So it is having the highest capacity, the longest length for this pump house. In terms of length, you know, it is about 375 meters. Almost we can say half kilometer, making some room for the approaches. So if you count that, it is becoming almost half kilometer that we can see here. And lot of substations we have constructed. Before Telangana, we have only two numbers of 400 kV substations. But whereas after getting our Telangana, we increased to six more 400 kV substations. So totally, we constructed 19 substations in a record time of 24 months, which is also not a possible thing, you know. In a short period, without project management by any agency, it's only in-house project management by all of us, and achieved this project successfully and commissioned. So these are the salient features of our barrages. So lift system. At a glance, we can see all the details of these three pump houses. So this shows the slide covering the quantities of concrete we have done. So we can see 89,15,417 cubic meters of concrete in a record period of 24 months. So that is a big achievement by the civil engineers of Telangana state with the support of IITs. You know, we have taken the guidance from the IITs and the local engineering colleges. The university colleges have been consulted. Whenever we got out, we shared our views with the senior people of different organizations like IIS Bangalore, NIRM Bangalore, and IIT Delhi. So such institutions have been involved in this huge construction work. So these are the cement consumption. You can see the consumption of cement, 25,76,000 metric tons of cement we utilized so far in this only link one, link two. This will not show the figures of other links. These are details pertaining to only two links out of seven links we have. So steel consumption, we can see almost 3 lakh tons, metric tons of steel have been used only in link one, link two. So a lot of steel, again, we have to use in other projects, which is a combination of 28 projects into one mega project of this Kaleshwaram. So I would like to share one video for about six minutes, which shows the real-time picture of the entire Link One project, this Kaleshwaram project. I have taken this video just 3 days back for the benefit of our friends here who are just sitting before me. You can see this video. This is a live video we have taken 3 days back at site. So this is a Medigata barrage where you can see a lot of water. It's almost 13 lakh cubics of water passed through this barrage. This barrage has been designed for 28.25 lakh cubics of water. But now so far we got 13 lakh cubics of water to be passed at this barrage location. So we can see the first pump house. It lasts only for 6 minutes. Kindly be patient so that we can have a live view of all these works done by us. So far I have shown only the slides having only details, but here we can see the live. So in the link one, we have all surface structures. In link two, all are subsurface structures. So regarding subsurface structures, I want to show you only video. No audio and no explanation, because it doesn't require any explanation to these videos, because I'm explaining everything there only by making some captions over the video. Many structures we have constructed. So all types of structures are involved in irrigation project of Kaleshwaram. We have all the requirements structures in this gigantic Kaleshwaram project. So that is the greatness of this, an engineering marvel of our nation. It's a pride of nation. What I call it as a pride of nation, and also pride of Telangana, and pride of all our engineers and all the agencies pertains to this type of construction. So here we are seeing the largest canal, the largest capacity canal of Telangana, and it is the largest capacity in our India. Earlier we have a largest canal in Gujarat, but that has been crossed by this canal. Its capacity is 3 TMC, that is 36,000 cubics. At a time, the water will flow into the canal. We have done this canal in a record time of 9 months only. We did the excavation and the lining and the construction of structures have been done in 9 months period under the guidance of Honorable CM Sir and the then Minister Garu. Here we can see a lot of animal structures. The first time we constructed animal crossings. So eco-friendly structures have been constructed wherever they are required as per the suggestion made by the Forest Department and Central Water Commission. So this is the entry into the second barrage. That is in the name of Saraswati. Our Honorable CM Sir made them in the names of God, Goddess, Lakshmi, Saraswati, and Parvati. And also, so as pump houses in the same names, Lakshmi, Saraswati, and Parvati. Then after that, in link two, we have two world biggest pump houses in the capacity, in the construction, in the engineering marvel. Everything is achieved in those works. Very challenging works have been done in the link two, where a lot of issues have come. They have overcome with the help of the government and also with the help of our elders in the construction field. So, yeah, thank you. It's regarding link one of the great gigantic engineering marvel of Telangana as well as India nation. They're proud of world structures. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Please be on the stage. Please be on the stage.
Sir, it's a mega, mega project when compared to what we do, which is equivalent to peanuts, too, when compared to that. And we talk about billions of dollars. You know, the dollar value is big. The real value is very infinitesimal when compared to what it does to the lives of many farmers. Another big round of applause for this wonderful thing. May I call upon Mr. Bhaskar Reddy Gaddam, the Board of Director PMI PCC, to felicitate Sri Venkateshwarlu garu.